we used to have 110,000 employees. We currently have in the Netherlands 21,000 employees, and it's, in my opinion, not possible to really focus 21,000 employees on one thing. You have to get it smaller.
You can see the examples in the banks now. There are people in the top not really knowing what the primary process in the banks is. They're not even knowing what kind of bank they are. Read the stories, read the interviews. They were busy with among each other, but not with the business. There's still people in the top, and it, for them, counts for everybody. You see, you can deal with in some situation with 15, maybe 20 people, and they only know 20 people out of the 200,000 part of the big organization. So they don't know what the other 19,980 people are really doing, what they're thinking, what their mentality is.
I worked in a division of IBM called Lotus Development Company. It's a well-known software. We never saw any, no one ever came to see us. So we were an important part, no one, ever. So the decisions that affected our lives were made by people we never spoke to.
What you see is that for some companies, the fact that they are big, the span of control is too big and that they cannot control it, that's true. So some bigger companies, for them it might be more efficient to be cut up in smaller companies, but I think a company, for example, which is building a plane, you can't do it with a lot of freelancers. You need a big factory, you need a kind of organization to build these big planes, you need an infrastructure.
The customer gets lost into the big company, and the people inside the big company have no clue what the customer really wants. And so there is a sort of barrier.
I would think the forms that we have of organizations today really came about in the late 19th century, middle to late 19th century, and it was based on the military command and control hierarchies. That was the only model they had in the late 19th century, mid to late 19th century. The only model was the military. That's how you organize men to do this sort of work. And Henry Ford very famously said, "I don't want to pay for the worker's head, I only want his arm." That's gone. That's really, I mean, we still have to manufacture things, but robots, technology, and very cheap labor has displaced that. Everyone has to make money in different ways, and all those things are forms of knowledge, persuasion, creativity, design, various things, because you can't make, you know, a perfect example of this is Milan. You go to Milan, it's the second richest city in continental Europe. There's no manufacturing in Milan at all. What there is design. And they make a lot of money at that. So we have to fight more in terms of creating wealth. It's not going to be on manufacturing, and the firms are still organized on manufacturing basis. And that all has to, it's going to change, will change, although I don't think many of them will voluntarily change. I think they'll just sink like the dinosaurs into the mud and never know why they died.